How's it going, folks? Gonna do a request for the song Blue by the Seatbelts and Yoko Kanno. This is my first request I'm doing of many. But this is a lesson. I actually did the play along about a year and a half ago. So I've had quite a few people asking me, hey, how do you play some of these chords? Because I made them all up. There's actually no footage or anything of the guitar player playing it. So I believe this is correct, but I could be off. So your guitar is going to be in standard tuning, first of all. And you're going to put a capo on the first fret. And as always, I'm going to play through all of the riffs, and then we'll do the breakdown afterwards. Here we go. I just made some of those things up, like the... there's a couple other little things I added in there that are different from the recording. I'm going to show you just how to play the basic chords, not the stuff that I throw in. So the first chord is going to be... This is a G sharp major, but you're playing it just like you would a G. Since you're capoed up, you're playing it in the same... You're going to pretend like this is the nut of the guitar. So you're playing a G sharp chord. That's going to be the 4th fret, 3rd fret on the 4th fret on the E string. 2nd. I get thrown off by this. 3rd fret on the A string, open G, open B. 4th fret on the B and E high E string and the B string. The next chord is going to be to the next chord, it's basically the same type of thing. You're just moving both fingers to the next two strings. So with that said, it's going to be the 4th fret on the A string and 3rd fret on the D string, and then the open G, and the, of course the 4th fret still on the B and high E string. Now the thing about this G sharp major, you can play this note if you want. I usually don't play that. To me it actually sounds better not playing it, so I just mute it. I set my finger right on top of the string and I play the other notes. Or if you want, you can note it. That's the difference. So this is how it sounds. Now this is I guess an F minor. I'm gonna get thrown off a lot by this capo, guys, so please don't take offense to that. Open E string, of course, with the capo. 3rd fret on the A string, 3rd fret on the D string, open G, 4th fret, and 4th fret on the B and high E string. Now going back to the C shape, C sharp. So together that sounds like this. That's the first part of the verse. Now the next part is pretty similar. I think it only does it once in the song, so you're gonna go like, start with the G sharp, the C sharp, the E minor, F minor, D sharp. You're just playing these last four strings. Of course, the 4th fret's muted on the B and high E. Sharp. So that's going to sound like this. Okay, so the next part is the walk down on the strings. That is basically starting with the C sharp. So that's going from the C sharp, D sharp, open D sharp, F. I'm playing an F? Yeah, I'm playing an F. So, F, G, G sharp, A sharp, C, C sharp. So again, that's then it's going to go into the bridge, which is a G sharp major. Same thing we've been playing the whole time. Now that's basically the 4th fret. I'm muting the next string down. Open D, open G. This time I'm fretting the 4th and the 3rd fret on the high E string. The 3rd fret on the high E, 4th on the B. So. This chord right here, I just made that up, but this is fretting wise, it's gonna be 4th. On the low E, mute the A string, 1st fret on the, 2nd fret on the D string, open G, 4th fret, fifth fret on the B, and 4th fret on the high E. And then you're going to go back to your G sharp. important how you play it, because depending on how you fret the chord, it's going to set you up better for the next difficult chord to play. So I usually make sure I'm starting my G like this, and using my index finger for the next chord. That way I have this finger to play the next chord that's kind of difficult to get to. And then this one. And then you can go back to the G. The next one is kind of a combination of what the bass does and the guitar. The bass definitely goes to a G, which is the third fret on the low E. You have to be careful with this note, because it can sound really dissonant with the chords if you don't mute the strings the right way. So, first one's going to be third fret, muted A, open D, open G, fourth fret, and fourth fret on the B and high E. Next chord is going to be continued on the third, continue to fret the third fret on the low E. Mute the A, D, G, open B, and the third fret on the high E string. That's how it should sound. And then the next chord is going to be... That's it right there. Make sure to mute the A string as always. First fret on the D, open G. Fifth fret on the B, and fourth fret on the high E. And then you're going to go to the first chord you started on for this note. All right, the next chord is a lot easier to play. It's an F minor of some sort. So it's open low E, third fret, and third fret on the A and D. Open G, fourth and fourth on the B and E string. Again, that's pretty similar to what the high notes have been doing this whole time. The only difference is you're going from the high E's fourth fret to the high E's third fret. And the same with this one too, these two change. Same on top for the high strings. It's going to be the fifth fret on the B and the fourth fret on the high E. Starting again at first position. So together that's going to sound like. Chord is going to be, it's pretty easy, seventh fret on the A string, sixth fret on the D, eighth fret on the G, and the ninth fret on the B. You're going to make sure to mute this string and this string. You don't want to play those. Same with this chord. You don't want to play the top and bottom strings. So you're going to stay on 7 for the A string, stay on 6 for the D, and now you're playing a 6 fret on the G string and an 8th fret on the B string. So you're going from this chord . These are pretty easy to play. You just have to make sure you don't hit the A or the low E string when you're playing them. So it's going to be the 4th fret on the D string, open G, 5th fret on the B, and 4th fret on the high E. Now you're moving that 5th fret on the B to a 4. a C sharp. So coming out of the bridge, it's kind of easy to get it mixed up with the verse, but it's actually different. Coming out of the bridge, you're going to play the G sharp to the C sharp, the F minor, back to the C sharp, the F minor again.